This is Ham Radio Now, episode number 402, AREDN Revisited. I'm David Goldenberg, your host, W0DHG, and about a week ago, took a day off work and went with some of the local AREDN folks in our area, mostly from Simi Valley area, and went up to Verdugo Peak and got to visit a repeater site and help them to install some AREDN nodes and get a little bit of a better taste of AREDN in the field to kind of follow up on our last show. So I recorded a bunch of video. Mostly this is going to be a video show. I will be talking over it. Recorded some stuff out in the field. Hope it's interesting to you, and I'm hoping to be able to bring you some more AREDN episodes in the future. So I'm just going to jump right into the video here. This is the bottom of the hill, Verdugo Peak, back at the 210 freeway inside of the gated area. There's a gate that locks this road. It's mostly a hiking trail. And I'm part of the caravan going up to work on the hill. A number of the different guys that went up to join me all had different projects to work on. John and Paul and Sean and Orv. Everybody had something different that they wanted to do. For the main location that we're visiting was the DARN repeater site on Verdugo Peak. DARN is a disaster area network. It's a repeater system that's linked in the Southern California area, primarily used to support ARES and RACES in the event of a disaster. Its owner is K6VGP, and they were nice enough to allow the AREDN folks access to their repeater cabinet, their location, and to let them put a number of the AREDN nodes up there, as well as give them power. And today's visit, we are adding a 3 gigahertz dish that's pointing back to the Santa Susana Pass. Thought it'd be kind of fun to show you what it looks like to drive up to a repeater site. This is courtesy of my dash cam. It's about a 20-minute drive up the hill, and so I did a little bit of it on regular speed, and at some point the repeater's going to ID, and then I turned it into turbo mode to speed up the journey up the hill. But just so
all right, people, Ham Radio Now, episode number 402, maybe. We are on the road headed up to the Verdugo Peak repeater site. We're going to do some AREDN today, and we might even get to look at the DARN repeater system. This is W0DHG, and I'll do probably a real opening for the show, but in the meanwhile, we're doing some dash cam video. Thanks to my Cobra 895 dash cam. And, yeah, there we go. It is a lovely drive.
From the desert to the sea and all of Southern California, this is Dick Van Dyke, and this is K6VGP with me, Mount Disappointment.
It's 9 a.m. It's 71.0 degrees, and the wind southeast at 3.5 miles per hour.
And that's the announcement from the DARN system at the top of the hour. That was really Dick Van Dyke.
So we're going to go to high speed mode here. You can see it's a dirt fire road. There are a number of hikers on there. When we reached the hikers, we slowed down and tried to kick up as little dirt as possible. But it is quite the drive up the hill. It was a beautiful day, about 70 degrees. Couldn't ask for a nicer day. It was a little hazy over the valley. There's been a number of fires in the Southern California area, and there's a lot of particulate matter still. So we couldn't see clearly very, very far. In the lower parts of the valley, you could see the mountaintops on the other side. Again, there were a number of projects that we did. We got into they put up a couple of interlink antennas for one of the DARN repeaters. There was two or three AREDN nodes that were either replaced or added. There were a couple guys that were up there. I didn't really get any good video of them, sorry. that we're working on. There's a digipeater, or is it a packet? I think it was a packet thing that was up there at the site, and they were like putting in new EEPROMs and soldering up cables to connect into one of the controllers, all out of the back of somebody's pickup truck. It was kind of cool. So we're winding the corner here. You can see really far. We're getting to the last little turn. There's this big red and white tower. That's all public service. Fire, police, and utilities. And that box in front of you, that shipping container in front, that's the DARN site up there on the
So
menu.
We're recording, and I will edit it out. You got to come a little closer. I won't bite you. Okay. So we're live here on Verdugo Peak, and I will let the gentleman introduce themselves.
I'm Paul Strauss, WD6EBY.
And
I'm Orv Beach, W6BI.
And we were up here today to work on the AREDN Mesh system, install a couple of antennas or dishes. And they're doing some other stuff on the DARN repeater system. You want to tell us about what you know about DARN repeater up here?
Yeah, basically DARN is, the DARN network is owned by Dick McKay, VGP, and Mike Lee, MJU. They maintain it, build it. They've got sites throughout Southern California. They're deeply involved with Los Angeles RACES, Red Cross, hospital nets, and during times of disasters, they turn their system over to them. And it's a very nice thing that they do to provide the service to the community. One of the things that they've done is they've allowed us to install mesh equipment at a couple of their sites, one of them here being Verdugo Peak. It has been a great boom to the Southern California mesh community. It's part of a gateway from our Ventura County mesh system into Los Angeles. And so far it's been working out very well. We've had a few hiccups, like every installation, but for the most point, we're ecstatic and very happy for the technology. In Ventura County, we have a backbone system that crosses the whole county, our own amateur-owned 5-gig system, and we have certain key points. We have pop-outs for the mesh technology and provides connectivity for our county, and then again that's extending into Los Angeles County. Did most of the design, installation, and Orv has done pretty much all of the firmware, software upgrades, the chief political IO person for what we're doing, and it's kind of the nuts and bolts. Orv?
Yeah, Paul's backbone across Ventura County stopped at Peak, and the DARN folks were very gracious in letting us hop on their microwave link from Peak on the LA to Ventura County line to here on Verdugo Peak, and more recently from here to Mount Wilson. And those two hops and the access points have allowed us to extend the mesh backbone from San Ynez Peak in the north clear down to the Mexican border. So it's about 260 airline miles, so it's growing very rapidly. We're pushing out all sorts of facilities like VoIP PBXs, webcams, pretty much anything you can put on the internet, we're moving over to adding to the ham radio, ham net, you could call it. The webcams proved their worth in the Thomas Fire in Ventura County last fall, so we're pushing out more cameras to more
cameras.
Sites. Yeah, mountaintop cameras.
So the connection here and to Mount Wilson allowed you to join up with the folks in Orange County and San Diego to bring you all the way down to the border?
Yes, sir. That's
okay.
Correct.
That's great.
And
yeah.
We have, we've done some, that interconnectivity is just a recent development, and we are starting to experiment with cross connections of PBX systems and chat rooms and video streaming. So when it's self-contained within the county, you know, we have our own issues, but every area does things a little bit differently, so we're trying to work on common standards and common practices and namings and doing things. So it's, you know, this whole thing's a learning process, but I tell you, we're having a great time with it. And the agencies that we've shown this to have been real receptive to it and are very ecstatic to see this coming online. So
great, that's great. So put some equipment up here. We're going to go over Peak and see what's over there and try to line up the two
Yeah, we just installed a 3-gig dish today between the Peak and Verdugo Peak. Hopefully it'll give us a lot better signal quality than the 5-gig, which is prone to a lot of interference. We're still operating within the amateur band, you know, being legal and stuff. We're just trying to improve the quality of the path around the area.
Right, and 3 gigahertz, as we talked about in the last show, was ham primary.
At this time, there is no commercial activity in the 3-gig band. Amateur is exclusive in their portion of the band.
Great. Well, that's super. Thank you guys for letting me come up and join you today. We'll do a little bit more video Peak, and then I'll snip everything together today and hopefully have another great show.
Very good.
Thank you guys for joining me today. I really appreciate that. It's been a lot of fun.
Thanks for coming up.
I'd like to continue along, and we'll see how we can't spread it around the Los Angeles area.
Pretty good.
Yeah. If you like computers and you like ham radio, this mesh networking is the great combination of both of them. Highly recommended.
Excellent. Excellent. Well, I'm looking forward to following up on it more.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you guys.
Take care.
Perfect.
So you can see the repeater box. That's it there. All those antennas are 2 meter, 70 centimeter, 220. I think there's a 900 megahertz. There's a bunch of Arden stuff in the beginning. There's a bunch of interlinks between the different repeater sites. And everything lives in that shipping container that's up on that concrete riser.
Put a couple wires on the contacts. Hook it up to a Raspberry Pi, point it at the air conditioner. That's probably what
the camera's up there so that they can remote in and look at how the site looks as the weather changes or if there's fires in the area. And when you go to work up on that sites, you gotta really make sure you bring everything you need because it's a long drive down to the hardware store. And that's that public service antenna tower there, a little fancier than what they've got. There's a view across San Fernando Valley and my yellow FJ.
John, as long as you don't put the frequencies in here.
Cool.
So we have community receive here.
That's John, one of the owners of the DARN system.
For most of the radios. This is DARN right here.
Right.
440 with PA, 2 meters.
Okay.
There's a remote base here that we're playing with, 2 meters and 6 meters.
Mm-hmm.
A stick that's up here. So you can turn on the remote base from the radio.
Okay.
Link 1, PV, Link 2, San Pedro, Link 3, Otay. Link 4 goes to Paul's radio in Ventura at Sulphur Mountain. And then this one's currently not going to anything. And that's a controller.
Just the controller?
That's the controller. 8 ports.
So now Herb's working on one of the, it's a rocket.
This won't mean much to anybody because it's a Linux.
He's trying to download an updated version of DARN. That was a refurbished unit that moved from somebody
else. Most of this I'll end up talking over.
It's a M2.
It'll make it more exciting.
Shit.
Version. He had a hard time getting into it for a while, but eventually he was able to talk to it. And flash updated firmware. Turned out I think we had a cable problem. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video
for a minute. This side, I'll cover Simi Valley.
All the video you saw up to this point was all at the Verdugo Peak location, and now we've driven across the valley. We drove out to a different location. This is in the Santa Susana Pass, and this is the site that's the target of the main dish that we put up. And we got to do some aiming and some adjustments. Orv gave me a good tour of the Arden equipment that they have here covering the Simi Valley and their cabinet. So I'm going to go ahead and play that and show you what's there.
Yes. This up here is a WISP.
Okay.
That's wireless internet service provider.
It was guaranteed there'd be nobody nearby. A year later, that popped up. In after put that down there. What a job.
Oh boy.
Let's see me. little 19 freeway there.
All right, so what do we got here?
So, off to the left, the small container there belongs to Paul Strauss, WD6. It was put up about 3 years ago. The equipment on the left side, west side of the container, actually belongs to the county.
Okay.
On the right side is UHF antenna for UHF repeater, and a 420 link antenna, Yagi, back to the rest of the system.
Right.
You can't see it, but underground is a large pipe, and it comes back under here.
Got it.
And what you got here is, all of this is our digital mesh equipment, except the Omni antenna, which is VHF repeater.
Okay.
It's also tight. So the large dish on the right is the eastern terminus for his backbone. Goes to Camarillo Hills, South Mountain, Sulphur Mountain. On the left is a Part 15 access point, that sector antenna. Upper right, that's the 5 gigahertz user access point for mesh.
Mm-hmm.
Upper left is a 3 gigahertz sector antenna, which is my local backbone for Simi Valley only. It goes west about 5 miles to a site on a water tank on Mellow Lane. Then it goes northeast to a site on the north end of Simi. So all of our local Simi traffic doesn't ride on the regular user access points. The little box in the middle is a NanoStation M5.
Yeah.
Oddly enough, that works very well for user access point for eastern Simi Valley because it's quite narrow here and the beam width fits fine. The little dish right above it is just a test system. We poured the concrete in 2014. With the tower and have gradually populated all the antennas there. Like I was saying, the container went in a couple of years later and we put the stairs in. Not too long ago, along the stairs, we laid 2 runs of underground Cat 5 cable up to the main container, which we'll see later.
Okay.
And that links the two networks together. That allows our network to proceed farther to the east.
To go to where we were before.
And that's about it about that.
Okay. Got a couple cameras here.
A couple cameras. That's up on a Part 15 watching there. And that's watching Simi. Because of the Thomas fires last year, it became obvious that ham radio frequently occupies sites where there's no governmental or commercial presence. And we had a camera on Sulphur Mountain that gave a great view of the approaching fire.
Right.
As a result, we're in the middle of upgrading all of those cameras from those cheapy tube cameras to really good quality pan tilt zoom cameras.
Right, like you have on the other, like you have on the other.
Yeah,
right.
That's government, but we'll be putting one
something
of ours
like that
up there.
Uh-huh.
Additionally, we're going to have more network connections through the tube. I put a pan tilt zoom camera on the North Simi Valley site. Got one scheduled for the West End. He's put one up on his site on Sulphur Mountain, south of Ojai. And the other thing we're doing is we're hardening the sites with better battery backup. I mean, the whole mesh network is 4 years old, basically. We're still building it out and learning how to run it.
Uh-huh.
But it's coming along nicely. On this backbone, end-to-end, I can do about 7 megabits per second total. And we've had video conferences and phone calls. It's a lot of fun.
So battery backup here, but there's power here?
No battery backup yet.
Okay.
Paul's got the batteries, he's building it out.
But you're getting ground power underneath?
30 amps from the main site.
From the main building,
yeah.
Okay.
We've got all those upgrades scheduled for September or October. Gonna run, there's a network switch in the little container there and it gets really ill when it gets hot.
Yeah.
So we're gonna relocate it over there and just run, I don't know, a dozen or so underground Ethernet cables to remote the switch from here. It works well now. Don't think we have any upgrades here other than the camera and the cabling and the batteries.
The little dish, that's a 5?
It's a little low gain 5 gig. It's just a test network. It's not used for any kind of production traffic. I want to show you one thing here. A little nanostation, which you'll notice it's encased in a metal shield.
Oh, yeah.
I forget the vendor. It's not very expensive. Uh-huh. And you wouldn't normally need that when you're running one of these at home. We have a lot of 5 gig WISPs up here.
Oh, to shield it.
And I put this up here.
Made a big improvement right away? Yeah.
Additionally, on this, it's going to be hard to see, on this 2 gigahertz access point, shield. It's a metal shield.
Uh-huh.
This improved the link quality for everybody that was using between 5% and 10%, and that's just shielding.
And what is all this stuff that's back here? So some of this is your stuff going forward, and some of this is other folks.
Tell you what's up there.
What's up here on the hill is some amateur equipment, some wireless internet service providers, mostly. Some other agency things that are up here. That telephone pole there with the single 3 gig dish on it, that's the mate to the one we just put up on Verdugo Peak.
Okay.
And we're going to be going up there to align that in just a little bit.
All three of us?
Oh, yeah, we'll all be up there.
Yeah, you'll be on the top with the camera shooting down at us.
That's that one.
And all the other antennas up there are repeater antennas.
Yeah.
Omnis and
yep.
Link right. antennas. And stuff like that.
Cool. All right, let's see the cabin in here. Let's see this.
In your shack. All right, I won't show any.
Let me turn the fan off.
Okay. Oh,
did you bring the filter down?
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotta replace the filter.
Yeah, it looked like you already did it.
Oh, you did?
The spares are over there. Already.
Okay. Did you swap one yet?
Yep.
Okay, good.
So, what's the repeater system that's here?
So, this is part of the. This is my radio network.
Uh-huh.
This is Pleasant Valley Amateur Radio Club, pvarc.club.
Okay, I'm going to switch over to that. That's a good segue. Here's the site for pvarc.club. And there's some great pictures here. It's a different location. This is the stack of equipment that they just talked us through at that Santa Susana site. This is them, the build party, I believe, of them putting in the base, the concrete base for this stack right here. You can see at the bottom of it. Dragging some concrete down and filling up and getting ready for it. This is, I guess, after they're getting it up and putting it all together. And then I think this is yet another location. That one didn't have solar panels. This is somewhere else. Pleasant Valley Amateur Radio Club at pvarc.club. Got a lot of good information here on the different stuff they're doing with mesh phones, cameras, links, other projects and stuff. So it's worth checking out. I'm going to go back to the video.
Okay.
And it's a series of VHF and UHF linked repeaters throughout Ventura County. This is one of 1, 2, 3, 4 sites, and soon to be 6 sites. Basically, Ventura kind of like a lot of areas of Southern California, a lot of valleys, so not one thing works in every place. So basically every major valley or community, we've got a repeater up, and we're expanding it. It's working very well. We've had great success with it, as we use a few emergency call-outs for ACS and ARES, and people seem to appreciate it. We put a lot of into it. There was a team that basically got the container and drug it down the path before
That's what Orr was saying.
Before there were steps.
Before there were stairs there.
And we ran power to it, cabling. I think it's not too bad of an installation.
Yeah.
I'm very impressed. Some people don't have it as good as this, and we are very blessed to have this.
Hey, David.
Yeah.
Brush fires here typically come from the northeast,
right?
From that direction. So if we get a pan tilt zoom here,
right, you'll be able
to project
right.
progress of fires.
This is up here.
Right. Yep. Right there, going down.
You can't see it through the haze, but my site on the north central Simi Valley has a pan tilt zoom looking towards Oak Mountain if it needs to be. So we can stream all of them to YouTube for the responsible agencies if they want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of times when you see the fire, it's up.
They get lots of fires along the freeway. anyway.
Yeah. It's all the smokers.
Or something. Ready to go up to the upper site, Paul?
Sure.
Ready to go up to the upper site.
So here goes Orv up the ladder. At this point, basically the challenge is just to get the dish there pointed at the other one that we put up, you know, about 20 miles away. And there's a tool that the Ubiquity folks put out. You can hear some beeping in the background there. And it gets faster and higher as you get a better signal. Makes it really easy for them to kind of dial it in. You can hear when he touched it, it brought it up a little bit.
Can we look and see if the camera's actually recording?
And it actually is pretty amazing because from the time they started moving it, it was only a couple minutes until. You kind of got it all dialed in, you know, you heard it right away.
Flashing red dot in the middle and the top.
And here's where I tried to remember, did I turn the camera on or not?
It's a solid red dot.
Yeah, that's great.
That's good, it's recording. Change a little bit there.
Don't get it too loose, it jams your fingers falling down.
Yeah.
Whoa! Minus 68, that's the best you're gonna do.
You think?
That's full scale. Lock it down, man. Now.
You don't want me to change azimuth anymore?
Well, okay, try it. I lowered the threshold for the beeps. Nope. Wrong way.
What are we at now?
Minus 70. Minus 67. Minus 68. 68.
I think that's all it's going to do.
Okay. We'll lock that down. We'll try elevation.
So that was directional, left and right, or what variation of east or the azimuth, and then there's a tilt up and down because we're at a lower spot than at this location than we are up at Verdugo Peak, so then they got to aim it up a little higher. That took just a couple minutes to do. You can see there's a lot of work to do, put in. They had to wire this pole. They had to put that pipe up. A lot going on behind the scenes, and this was already here, obviously, when we got there from previously week's trip. going to speed it up a little bit here. Orv's way at the top of the ladder now. It was 19 before is what he was saying. I think I got that wrong at the end when I close it.
This will no longer be a bottleneck.
So this is passing the data from up north to through the Los Angeles area. And again, it gets it all the way down to San Diego. Peter's done for the day, and we did all the stuff that we need to do. I'm just going to get Orv down the ladder, and then I'm going to close it out.
Okay. Yep.
It was a really fun day. I had a lot of good time up there. I learned a lot about the Arden stuff.
You said they're gonna
different types of hardware. There's lots of different kinds of equipment that they use from Ubiquiti. And some TP-Link stuff as well. We're looking to add it to our toolkit here as well. In the San Fernando Valley, they did some tests yesterday with a similar dish to this pointing up at Mount Wilson to bring it down to the ground, as it were, and be able to spread it out across the valley.
So we're getting ready to wrap for the day. Put in that new rocket dish there, and I think the site was getting, I think they said 17, and now we're getting about 130 megabits through. Big improvement for the day, a lot of fun. Looking forward to bringing you this episode. Hope everybody enjoys it. This is W0DHG, over and out. But this won't really be the ending.
Yeah, so it's not really the ending. This will be the ending. Anyhow, I want to show you, before I get to the ending, actually, let me show you one more thing here. When we look at the mesh, here's a good picture. This is from the Santa Barbara Amateur Radio Club. It kind of shows you the interconnects between the system and all the infrastructure that they put in place all across Southern California. If I zoom out, you can see, you know, all the way down to T1, all the way up into Santa Barbara, almost all the way to Lompoc, and inland pretty far. There's a lot of infrastructure there. There's a lot of potential support in an emergency situation if we need to, as amateur radio operators, provide services to different served agencies in the community. There's a lot of value in it. So again, I hope you enjoyed episode number 402, Arden Revisited. I am David Goldenberg, W0DHG. If you like what we're doing, it's free for you to watch. It's not free for me to make. I am kind of continuing on here. Lots of you miss Gary. I miss Gary too. But it was time for him to want to take on some other challenges. But part of the reason I wanted to keep this going is there are 400 episodes behind us, and I want to keep those available. There's a lot of good information there. I get as many folks commenting on my new shows as there are folks that are going back through the library and watching the old shows that Gary did. So I want to honor that and keep it there and make it available for you. So if you like what we're doing, please come visit hamradionow.tv. Find Arvin and click the pig and help support us. Thank you very much for watching. This is W0DHG, over and out. 7-3 all.